Private King are being sponsored by a certain high street chemist's makeup range. But who on earth would have dared to sponsor Kiss when they were in their heyday? I don't know. Well, for all of those of you who thought that Kiss had been sunk by their makeup, fear not, because they're back, they're still plodding away, and they've got a new LP out soon. Although they've abandoned all that eyeliner and evil imagery stuff in a last bit attempt to be taken seriously, although I don't think it's going to work somehow. Anyway, axe-wielding Mark Ellen went along to Wapping to offer his services.
Now, the Whistle Test programme is always sending its presenters off to exotic locations, New York, Los Angeles, Bermondsey, and it is indeed the latter that I'm speaking to you from, in the shadow of Tower Bridge, Greater London over there, the heart of London's dockland. Paddle steamers passing, seagulls. We've spared no expense. We've hired this luxury barge here to entertain two members of a very famous supergroup, I believe the expression is, Kiss. And here they are now. So why did you take the makeup off?
You do something too long and you wind up being a caricature of yourself. You wind up being a copy of yourself. To a lot of fans, to a lot of the new fans, the makeup isn't even relevant.
I always figure that, you know, life's like a one-way trip, so you might as well dress for a good time, so, you know.
As you can tell, he's really dressed today.
And this is the best way to have fun.
Flies are coming undone gradually. I'm getting terribly worried about
it. It's all right.
Three or four inches.
It's all right. You're looking...
I'll try to speed my questions.
If my fly comes down, the camera goes over.
When you took your makeup off, there was a whole generation of new metal groups who moved into that position and took up where you left off, people like Motley Crue. Is that kind of thing flattering?
Yeah,
sure
absolutely.
Sure. Because those bands eventually are either going to live or die by their own devices, their own talent. It's great.
Every band is initially influenced by others, but...
I thought you were going to say every band is eventually influenced by us.
But I tell you, it makes me sleep real well knowing that nobody ever accuses us of being like a Kiss copy. You know, we're not a Kiss copy band. We never have to worry about it.
I mentioned Motley Crue because there's this movement at the moment in America to try and instate certificates on LPs to make sure that LPs by people like Motley Crue do not get sold to minors because they're considered to be corrupting. Do you think that's a good idea at all?
I think everybody should be, if a minor can buy one, then pipe fitters can buy
them. Do you call them miners here?
Not.
I don't think they call them miners. A miner is somebody that goes underground. And...
Yes.
Got lost. So do you feel that Kiss are being seen as grandfathers of this this movement that's corrupted the youth of a once great nation?
I think the most positive effect we've had is we've increased the population of every country we've been to, and that's okay.
You're family men, then,
are you? Oh, yeah. It's just that we have a very big family.
Very
all.
Big family.
Are you trying to be taken more seriously then?
Could we be taken seriously? You're damn right we could.
50 million fans can't be wrong.
Folks at home, take us seriously, but take us.
All we wanted to know what a minor was that was Kiss, of course. Now, it is that part of the program.